You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, December 11th, 2018. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are working our way through the Moses section of the Jesse tree. Yesterday, we talked about how the Israelites ended up in Egypt and how Moses ended up growing up as an Egyptian prince. Today, we are going to talk about Moses' encounter with God, which was far beyond anything that anyone had experienced in the Old Testament so far. So, of course, Moses grew up as an Egyptian prince, and as events unfolded, he realized that he was actually an Israelite slave. Moses decided to protect an Israelite slave who was being attacked, and eventually Pharaoh himself exiled Moses. He was sent out into the desert where he was expected to die. But Moses made his way across the desert. He found relatives whom he worked with and raised sheep. He eventually married a woman and began a family, and he was a shepherd. One day, while grazing his sheep at the foot of a mountain, at the foot of Mount Sinai, he looked up and he saw a fire that seemed to be burning on a bush, and yet the bush wasn't burnt up. He was very interested by this, so Moses went up the mountain to explore. The bush on fire was actually the presence of God. As Moses approached the bush, God told him to remove his shoes, for he was standing on holy ground. Moses, of course, was a little bit terrified, so he fell on the ground before the bush, but he had a conversation with God. In this conversation, God told Moses that he had heard the cries of agony from the Israelite nation who were slaves in Egypt, that he had heard them and that he had a plan, and that his plan was to send Moses. Moses, of course, was hesitant. I mean, who was he to go and fight Pharaoh and free this nation of slaves? But in this conversation, Moses also asked God what his name was. God told him that he was the God of Abraham, the God of his ancestors, but he also gave the name Yahweh. This is what God called himself, Yahweh. Now, Yahweh is a very sacred name. In fact, for a long section of history, it was too sacred to even say. But understanding what Yahweh means can reveal a lot about the nature of God. The best translation of the word Yahweh is simply, I am. So God's name is I am. Now, does that make sense? I know it's a little bit hard to understand, but God is telling us that he simply is. Now, let's talk about the issue of naming things for a moment. When a new baby is born, who gives that baby a name? Its parents. When your family gets a pet, who gives that pet a name? Well, you and your family do, of course. We name things that we have control over and in a way that we have responsibility for, or even things that we own. So we give a name to things that we produce or protect. Well, who produced God? Who has ownership of God? No one. God simply existed. God existed before all other things. God is all things. All things came to being through God. So God simply is. I know that's a complex and powerful idea to understand, even if you're an adult, But knowing that God simply is, God didn't have a beginning and he won't have an end, is a glimpse into the power and might and majesty of God. So God selected Moses to go do this great work in Egypt and to bring the entire Israelite nation to freedom. Now, as we think about the burning bush, I want you to embrace this challenge today, Sprouts. I want you to spend just a couple minutes reflecting on God. God is huge. Sometimes, and it's okay to be a little bit overwhelmed by the concept of God, but the idea that he created all things, that he existed before all things, that he will have no end, and that he can do anything. Reflect on that. Reflect on the fact that this powerful being is our God, but also our Father who hears us.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God intended you to be. One final word to the grown-ups. Thank you so much for listening to the Catholic Sprouts podcast. I would like to invite you to join a special Facebook group just for those that listen to the Catholic Sprouts podcast. We will use this group to connect, to share resources around that week's theme, and simply celebrate raising future saints. To find the direct link to the Facebook group, simply check the notes for this podcast episode.